It's the Back in Blue video podcast.
Hey everybody, welcome to Back in Blue 28. We're in the house again. Thank you for tuning in, checking us out. Nick, you just got back from your honeymoon. You went to Vegas. What'd you do? Did you have fun? Good time? Any stories?
Yeah, man, all that and a whole lot more.
Right on.
Lots of fun, it's a great time, and lots of stories.
Great.
Does that sum it up?
We're going to have an extra after the show, story time?
If I won a little bit more money, we would, but, you know, a little bit of gambling, lots of walking,
yeah,
lots of heat. Pretty cool. Hit up the Hoover Dam. That was my highlight. But
nice. Yeah. There you go. And you said you tried to get to the Las Vegas 51s game. It was kind of far away. You didn't go. That's all good, though.
Yeah, I was trying to check out the stadium, but it was a distance, and they're actually on the road. They had the All-Star break, just like the MLB, and their road trip, so it didn't work out. I couldn't even find any gear. I was surprised. They didn't sell too much 51 stuff in the mall, even, so kind of disappointing, but...
No love for the 51s.
Yeah, that's all right. Yeah, that's
all good. But we're happy to have you back. Glad you had a good honeymoon. Congrats on the wedding.
Thank you.
Amazing.
Thanks for coming, man. Brad was there. It was a great time, and like it feels great to be back. I know you're feeling good to be here. Brad's ready to get going, and
absolutely
been missing it.
It's time to get down to business. Let's talk Jays and start off with Jays trending. Number one on Jays trending, the Jays have signed Edwin Encarnacion.
Yeah, I was pretty jacked when I heard that one. I didn't actually find out till I got home. There wasn't too much news going on down in Vegas about the Blue Jays, unfortunately, but. When I got home, I was definitely excited to hear that. I've been hoping they would sign him all along. I didn't want them to move him in a trade or anything. So I'm jacked. How are you feeling?
Well, I feel good about it. You know, they got the deal done mid-season. Edwin's got a nice stride going on right now. I do get a little bit worried that these big signings can kind of alter their play. But I got a feeling that Edwin's not going to be affected. He's going to come out and play strong. Big congratulations to him, because that's an amazing thing in this player's career to sign a contract like that for a lot of money.
Yeah, for sure. No doubt.
And,
who wouldn't?
Oh, my God, yeah. And as Jays fan, I'm pumped. I think he deserved it. I think he's got even more in the tank over the next several seasons.
For sure. And he got a three-year deal with a fourth-year team option. And he celebrated with a bomb of a home run over Windows Restaurant in left center. I didn't see it live, obviously, but I caught a highlight, a replay of it a couple times, and it was a bomb. Yeah. I couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
It was a bomb.
I actually, you guys just explained to me, I unfortunately missed it too. We've all been crazy busy the last little while.
Yeah.
But to put a ball that high over the restaurant, absolutely incredible. And I think I was mentioning before the show how I think a lot of people take it for granted just how far these guys hit a ball. When they hit it 400 feet straight dead center field, that's a long ways.
It was, and the lady who, I don't think she caught it, she probably dove out of the way, but she picked it up off the ground. She was ecstatic. She couldn't believe that she got a ball up there. There was only a few people, and it was pretty cool. So it was great to see that. It's great to see him with here for a few more years.
Oh, yeah.
And hopefully keeps going on the same pace.
Next on Jays trending, Joey Bats in the Home Run Derby and the All-Star Game.
Yeah, he finished second in the Derby. Pretty good showing. Unfortunately, Prince got the better of him.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think of the Derby?
Yeah, the Home Run Derby I thought was a lot of fun. Of course, anytime you see a Blue Jay in the Home Run Derby, it becomes that much more exciting.
It always.
So, of course, we were pulling for Jose, and I think he had a pretty good showing.
Yeah, he did. He I think he lost 12-7 in the final.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, he came up a little bit, really short last year. He didn't make it the first round. So to
and
see
that
him
almost happened again this year.
Really? I didn't actually catch the beginning.
At the start, I was like, uh-oh, it's going to be a repeat of last year. And I think he hit like 5 or 6 on his last out
First
round
to
put up an impressive 11. So I was like, oh, sinking heart feeling like he's not doing it again.
Yeah.
But he really got together and earned his shot in the semifinals and then finals. So
it's good to see him get a little bit hot just like he does in the regular season.
Yeah, man. Those high and tight fastballs, I'm trying to talk to his pitcher. I'm like, high and tight, high and tight.
Yeah, no
doubt. Put him high and tight. Keep putting him there because he just turns on the ball so well, like we all know. And with the Home Run Derby, though, so much of it clearly and obviously has to do with your pitcher. And his pitcher was so-so.
Yeah, you weren't too impressed, eh?
No, last year I thought he was worse. But, you know, it's still up to the batter to swing or not. But you're really getting that groove. And I saw the pitcher start hitting some spots. And Batista's like, bring it in, right there,
He
just looking, just getting settled, you know. And you could see when you get off kilter, when you get several pitches that aren't good in a row, and then you get those good ones, but you're missing them because you're not in that groove. It's so important for the pitcher to put them where they need to be.
Yeah, and he really relies on his timing with his high leg kick, and it does get messed up. And just a quick touch on the All-Star game. I definitely didn't catch that because I was there my first day. But, you know, the All-Star game's kind of lame in some ways. It's not too exciting. Well, and unfortunately, you got the World Series on the line. Like, I don't like that.
Yeah, I don't think that. I think there could be several other things that they can choose who gets home field advantage in the World Series Finals. But the American League got their butts kicked. They lost big time.
Yeah, and I think it's the third year in a row the NL gets the advantage. So someone go knocking on Sea League's door and get them a change at, because it's just a brutal rule.
Mm-hmm. Next on Jay's trending, Sergio Santos setback.
Yeah, I think he's trending every 3 to 4 weeks. Another setback. It always seems to pop up. And unfortunately, he's going to be out. I think they said it's at least until spring training next year. It's confirmed now. I think I said that a few weeks ago, but now it is confirmed. And it's kind of frustrating. But, you know, we've had the bullpen backing him up this year, too. So,
yeah, I mean, Jansen stepped in and done an incredible job in his replacing him. Coco, not so much, but that's in the past.
That's right.
I think the Jays got a little bit of a curse with their who's supposed to be their closers. I'm thinking back of BJ Ryan a little bit, and that was a disaster. It didn't go too well. And now here we go, Santos on the shelf till spring training. Jeez.
Yeah, I feel like they haven't had anyone locked down in the position. I know Ryan had a great year there. He got 50-some saves or whatever it was. But since, you know, the Terminator, Hanky, and Ward, I should say, actually, I guess he was the closer after. But you want to find someone that's going to come in there every game. Although today we had, I think they were saving Jansen for the Yankee series coming up. Apparently that's what they're saying. And they had Oliver close up the game with six outs. So, you know, that was good to see, too.
I love Oliver, man. Yeah, he's been amazing.
Yeah, he's a stud, and he's an OG.
Oh, definitely, man.
For sure.
Sacramento boy. We got the chance to talk to him early in BIB, and he...
Yeah, he's I think
he laid the law down for us, told us what it's all about.
Yeah, I think he was my first interview now. And,
there you go. Not
bad. It was cool to talk to him, and... sorry, I lost my train of thought. But to see him, he hadn't actually had a save since it had been a ton of years since, and his last one was against the Blue Jays. Mm-hmm. And he actually went 14 years in between saves at one point. So I thought it was kind of crazy.
Good for him, man. And six in his career, so obviously he's not the save
guy. Yeah.
But
I wish I talked to him more about that.
Yeah, we could have. Actually, when we talked to him, he talked about one of the things when we asked what he's going to bring to the team. He mentioned, you know, just helping out the arms in the bullpen, and he was preaching about how important it is to stay healthy and stay in good shape. And unfortunately, even though those were positive intentions, we've been riddled with injuries in the bullpen.
That's right.
Yeah.
And hopefully, you know, good luck to Santos also recovering, and we're wishing him a quick recovery and good health, I guess.
Yeah, I guess.
However you want to say it.
Get well soon, Santos.
That's right.
And now it's time for Nick's Blue Jay of the Week.
This week's Blue Jay of the Week is Carlos Villanueva. I didn't do my usual blog, but we collectively came up with the decision, I guess you could say.
Yep, we did.
You suggested it. I give you credit.
Absolute game time decision. We figured it out right before the show started.
Yep.
And I think he deserves it without a doubt. It was a slow week, obviously, but he's pitched 12 straight shutout innings in a row. This is a guy who is not supposed to be their starter. He's in the starting position, been thrust into that position. I touched on it earlier in the year saying that there's going to be injuries. There's going to be guys that are going to have to step up. If they don't, the Jays are in big trouble.
Yep.
Guys like Villanueva are keeping this team's head above water.
For sure. And I was actually on the boat of keeping him in the bullpen before he got the move to the rotation. I loved what he brought out of the pen. You know, he came in and he was solid, but it's great to see him such a strong part of the rotation now also. I'm not going to complain about that. They've still got the bullpen strength. So, you know, it's great to see him excel when he gets a chance.
Earlier in the show, we were talking about Santos and his troubles, and we heard some interesting stuff from Zaun today on the Jays broadcast. He was talking about how maybe Santos has some mechanical issues that could lead to problems, and he brought up an interesting point that maybe Chicago had a little more information about Santos's delivery, his style, and that it could lead to problems, or maybe they already knew that he had problems. Zaun suggested this little conspiracy theory. What do you think?
Well, he never actually called out AA. I think he tiptoed around his words, or I don't know if he was doing it on purpose, but he made the comment about Kenny Williams, the White Sox GM, maybe
Kenny Williams.
Yeah, maybe getting the... for some reason, Kenny Rogers pops in my head there. Roasted chicken, not the pitcher. But anyhow, Kenny Williams maybe got the upper hand on AA, or in the deal at least, by, you know, he got a prospect back. It was only one prospect, but, you know, he got Nestor Molina back. Yeah. And maybe he kind of had an idea that Santos was going to have some injury woes.
Yeah, I think the thing that why Zaun's bringing that up is that, well, it seemed like a little too easy almost, the deal. You'd think Santos would be worth a little bit more considering the big year he come off of there. So with Santos being hurt, Zaun was just bringing up that, yeah, there could be something there. And I'm not sure, really. I mean, maybe there is, maybe there's not. Zaun's a catcher, so you know he's keen on pitchers and their deliveries, what's right, what's wrong, what can potentially lead to injuries, what might not. But I don't know. Interesting.
Yeah, it is. And, you know, Santos has only pitched for about 3 to 4 years. I think it's less than 4 years still.
Yeah,
so
that's incredible in itself.
It is. And he's really transitioned very quickly from infielder to pitcher. Mm-hmm. And, you know, his mechanics are still developing. He's still a young pitcher as far as that goes. And it's going to be interesting to see how he comes back. And we want to hear what the fans think, what the Bib fans and the Blue Jay fans think. And do you think maybe Williams got the upper hand, or do you think they knew something was up?
Yeah.
You know, what are you thinking? Let us know. Hit us up on Twitter, Facebook, anywhere.
Call me.
Yep. 555 skip 101.
Yeah, that's it.
You'll get someone there. Just talk to the operator.
Someone will answer. But yeah, it's an interesting topic, though. Really interesting. We'd like to hear what you guys think, too. Because and also, what do you think the Jays should do with Santos for the future as well?
Definitely.
Now he's on the shelf till spring training, and that sucks.
It does suck. I think we need to move on from Santos, becoming a bit of a downer talk there. And let's talk about the upcoming week. They're going to Yankee Stadium for 3 games and going to Fenway for 3. I think it's absolutely huge.
I think so, too. And I think the Jays should bring me out on that trip because they'd have a lot of fun.
And you want to go to both stadiums, eh? Just to go watch, or you thinking of the bullpen? What are you feeling?
I'm thinking just
to be there?
Be there.
Just to root them on?
Yep.
That'd be pretty cool. Actually, two of my friends are going down in September, too. They're sitting like 4 rows behind home plate at Fenway. I'm pretty jealous of you.
Yeah.
And that's going to be sick. But yeah, this week is absolutely huge. I know we said it plenty of times earlier in the year. I felt like we're saying it every week. Is that Pop Fly there?
Pop Fly.
Bugging you? But yeah, I think hopefully, I hate to say it, but you know, we're going 500 all year. We got to win 4 or 5 games.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I won't be happy with 3-3.
I want 12 in a row.
12, let's go.
Even though they're playing 6 games.
Yeah, that's okay. We can continue to the next week. Let's do it up.
Yeah.
And yeah, let's get a sufficient winning streak going. We need to win some ball games. We need to, we're not going to catch the Yanks. They're 20 games above 500.
Mm-hmm.
But let's get in that wild card spot.
Absolutely.
Craving it.
Come on, Jay-Z. You know that they're preaching that in the change room, too. They got to be doing that down in the, before the games, after the games. You know they're talking about getting that wild card spot. You know they still want it.
Oh, they want it bad. And you know they're gearing up strong for the second half, just as we are. We're really jacked for the second half. And, you know, the first half is over. Only 500 at the break, 43-43, I believe it was.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, all the support the fans have been given to them and given to us has been great.
Mm-hmm.
It's always appreciated.
Absolutely.
Like I said, guess over 1,000 at Back in Blue 2012.
Yeah, we're close, man. We're close to 1,000 on Twitter, so yeah.
Keep retweeting
all our goodness and all that fun stuff, and we really appreciate the support we've got from you guys already.
All right, I've got about 4 hours sleep, so I think we need to take off.
Let's get out of here.
All right.
Back in Blue, baby. Bam.
Oh, don't forget.
Back in Blue is sponsored by Logicor, Focus on the Core, and Anjack Limited, your roofing and wall cladding specialists.